Hi, I'm Luke.
I'm Tim. We're from Protest the Hero. And today we're going to be going over the riffs in Sequoia.
So to start off, a lot of people ask me what this little guy is for, this hairband here. And it's not like I don't tie my hair up during a show. It's for the first riff in Sequoia Throne, which is this. Or sped up. The reason I use this is because it deadens the strings a bit. It's kind of like if Tim had an extra hand, he could hold it over my guitar like this, and it would stop them from ringing. But because I'm using both hands up here to tap, I can't do it. I mean, some guys might be able to, but I can't, so I use this guy. And then the next riff in the song doesn't use it, or I don't use it again until the very end. So what I do is I quickly slide it down. And I don't know if you can see this, but this is my favorite part about this guitar, is when you slide it down, it kind of floats off the strings. So like it would be here, I use it on the fourth fret and then slide it down quick and it like floats off so that you could play anything open. But it's still there to slide back on quick. I don't know if you can do that with other guitars, I haven't tried, but this one's good for it, so. Do you want to play it with?
Yeah, over that, I just, over the lead, I just have a rhythm that's kind of like chugging on the open E. Kind of stuff like that. It's palm muted and alternate picking kind of thing. You want to play it together?
Sure. You count it, though. So yeah, during the, I'm kind of going and sliding this down so that we can get into the next riff, which is this slow.
And I pretty much do the same thing until the harmony. At the end.
That's a little legato run with three notes per pick, but you're going.
And I have the same, well, not the same run, I guess. Are we harmonizing that?
Yeah.
That's harmonized, so I'm going. And then in context. Leads us into a tapping riff. Where do you want to play your rhythm first?
Yep, it's just a B and a G.
So while he's doing that, I'll add my tapping riff. The tapping riff is easier than it sounds or looks. What it is tapping here constantly, and then with your right hand, or left if you're lefty, tapping and then coming down. Mm-hmm. Then switching down to the 9th and 12th fret. Now it's just. Right? That one is a little bit bigger of a stretch, but. Which gets me right back into the. Then we have.
And into a little chug part. My voice is changing. But then after that, yeah, it does the intro riff again, then we go into a little chug riff. So. Me to go through that slowly. The only thing is a muted E, then a little harmonic on the fifth.
Leads into a rock riff. Is pretty lame, but that's what we call them, so. Up to speed. And there's some runs in there that are using those notes. I don't know, maybe we should just go through it. It's hard to explain it. Would be the next part, which is stupid. I don't know why we wrote this, but it's kind of a chopped up legato part. That same thing that we always do with that. Three notes per string, and it's. You want to play that with me?
Yeah. Just.
Major scale, and we just chopped them up so that they were a bit techier of a rhythm.